My name is Kim Cunio. I'm an oud player. I'm actually a composer as well, and I make lots of music in lots of ways. But I came to the oud quite young in life, actually, because I was looking to really get in touch with my own culture. In my father's side, he's an Iraqi Jew, so I had the music of Iraq in my mind as a child. It's such beautiful music, it really moved me. And then when I was an adult, I really wanted to take up an instrument from my culture. And so I decided to take up the oud. But then when I spoke to my father about it, he said, well, don't forget that my father was from Turkey, from Izmir, Smyrna. And so when I wanted to find an oud, I really wanted to get a Turkish instrument because I always loved their sound. And I found this incredible instrument that you can see here from a whirling dervish troupe that came to Australia in 2001. So I've had this instrument literally for 20 years, been playing it with love. It's such a pleasure to play it. And the reason is it has an unusual sound. This instrument has a bigger bass than most ouds. It's almost like a double bass at the bottom. And then it has this sort of cantabile singing tone at the top. So it's almost like two different instruments. It's in an age where all instruments start to sound the same. I've been able to share with you an instrument that is really a one-off, that has been played really for sacred practice, and then it's come into my life where I've really spent hours and hours with it. So what is the oud? The oud is an 11-string fretless lute. It's essentially Middle Eastern, but it also had some really interesting times where it got to do with Europe quite a bit. Because when the Islamic empires took over Europe in the medieval period, they took the oud, and the oud over time became the gittin and the lute and then the guitar. So when I play my oud, I'm playing the instrument that made your guitar possible.